Bloodstain pattern analysis can help to tell the story of a violent crime. By examining the size, shape, and position of bloodstains, investigators can piece together how a wound was inflicted and what happened next. Bloodstains can be distributed if there is an impact into wet blood, a gunshot, from an injured artery, or the victim's mouth. Plus, it can appear in transfer stains, such as if someone wiped a bloody hand onto fabric. To an expert, these all look different. A spherical droplet of blood will form a circular stain if it lands directly onto a flat, smooth surface. An elliptical bloodstain shape means the droplet hit the surface at an angle, and the tail points in the direction the droplet was travelling when it hit. Combining data from all these droplets, the blood spatter, means investigators can build up a picture of where the blow was struck and sometimes what sort of weapon inflicted it. For a gunshot wound, blood spatter will usually form a mist which travels away from the entry wound. Larger droplets and tissue can develop from an exit wound and travel in the same direction as the bullet. The spatter produced will depend on factors including the size of the bullet, how far away the victim was from the gun, where the bullet hit them, and where they were standing relative to walls and objects. The overall features of the spatter can be used to reconstruct where the victim was located when they were shot, and can help to understand who was close by when that happened. All this information can be used to corroborate or refute witness statements. Perhaps a suspect is covered in the victim's blood, but they say they came across the already wounded victim and performed first aid. Analysing how the blood has been deposited on their clothing, the victim and the scene can help to understand if they are telling the truth or not. When combined with other forensic techniques, bloodstain pattern analysis is a powerful tool that investigators can use to look at the circumstances of crime.